Welcome back to Buckeye Bigfoot. Hello, everyone. I know it's not Friday or Tuesday, and I don't care. I could not wait to put this story together for all of you. I get lots of great emails with really good encounters, but few of them actually give me the heebie-jeebies. But this one did. I mean, does. This one does give me the heebie-jeebies. For tonight's snacking pleasure, I highly recommend a gooey dip of some sort, or maybe at least a pizza with extra cheese and lots of extra red sauce. Dig in, everyone, 'cause we're getting started. Nance, I debated about whether or not to send this in, because my story isn't something that's easy for me to tell. When I do, I start feeling all of the things I felt the day that it happened, and none of those things are good. I heard you say the other week about how you thought not all Sasquatch were good or bad, that they might be just like people, and maybe they're bad if they have young ones around. But I ran up on one in another situation that I would say definitely makes them a serious threat. I'm here to tell everyone that Sasquatch are not salad munchers. They are definitely predatory meat eaters, and I do not doubt that they would not hesitate to eat a human. I don't imagine that we look any different to them than any other animal they run across. I was in the Grand Teton National Park in 2008. I'd hiked up to Grand Viewpoint. Below and spread out to the east are two lakes. I forget their names. Anyway, I decided to hike down the middle piece of land between the two lakes. Mostly, I wanted away from an annoying family that had a bunch of kids. No matter how much I tried, we kept getting bunched up together on the trail. Kind of like how in the grocery store, where no matter how much you try, you keep getting stuck in the same aisle over and over with the most annoying, slow-walking person in the whole store. Even if you skip a few aisles, you turn the corner to find them right there again. Yeah, that's how it was with me and that family with annoying kids. Those kids were annoying AF. Anyway, there's a good mix of timbers and open areas through the land between those lakes. I had been through this area many years before, and if I remembered right, I knew that if I cut off to the left, I would head down toward the northern of the most of the two lakes. It was afternoon, about 2 o'clock. This was also in July. I was walking through a patch of timber. There was a lot of down timber throughout that area, I should add. Ahead, I could see the brightness that lit up one of the open areas between the big runs of timber. I slowed down when I was within 100 or 120 feet or so from the edge of the timber line. Something caught my eye. There against the brightness, I saw something dark at my 2 o'clock position. I stopped to be sure what I was seeing. When I first saw the profile, I thought I was looking at a bear that was leaning up against a piece of that down timber. There was a slope of shoulder and a massive girth that I took to be a bear's fat bottom. But then I saw the clear definition of legs, and legs that had knees, and they were bent because it was sitting on that piece of down timber. I could not see ears or a long snout or paws. The timber it was sitting on was at an angle to my position, so it was sitting at an angle that made its profile and its movements easy to see against the brightness that backlit the area beyond where it sat. Now, the lack of a snout and paws were what I noticed missing first, and for a very unsettling reason. The creature was holding something in its lap, and from the side profile of it sitting there, I watched, and I could see clearly that it was digging into whatever it was holding, and then lifting something to its mouth. I stood there puzzled for maybe 5 or 10 seconds, just watching it make the repeated motion of dipping down to that thing in its lap, and then bringing its hand, yes, a hand, not a paw, up to its mouth. I was very confused, but it was clearly eating something. But as much as my eyes were telling me what I was seeing, I was having a really hard time with it. I was blanking out. I couldn't connect the dots on what I was seeing. Then it lifted the thing from its lap and began to tip it towards its mouth. And all I could think of is it looked exactly like how my kids drink the last bit of milk out of their cereal bowl. Then I could see that what it was holding and what had been in its lap and what it had tipped towards its mouth was some kind of animal's head, or skull to be exact. There was an elongated snout on the skull that I could see against the outline from the sun behind it. There was no lower jaw to the head, and it might have still had fur on it, I'm not sure. It didn't look white, but I was certain that I saw teeth. But it was crystal clear to me that it was holding a skull. Now suddenly, all those dots that I couldn't connect before suddenly started connecting themselves, and I did not like the picture they were making. Somehow, I had walked right up on a Sasquatch eating a kill. How it hadn't heard me, I don't know. I guess it was more focused on eating, or maybe it couldn't hear anything beyond the sounds it was making eating. I don't know. But I did know that one of the most dangerous places you can ever find yourself is near a predatory animal that is eating its kill. And that's right where I was. And I knew I needed to get out of there. And I couldn't think of anything beyond that. I had to get out of that area, and before my brain could really instruct my feet on what to do, my feet started moving on their own, and I was trying to walk backwards without looking where I was going. I just couldn't bring myself to take my eyes off of what I was seeing ahead of me. I also vaguely was aware that I had a fear that if I turned to look at where I was going behind me, that when I turned back around, that thing would be right there in front of me like some horror movie. Anyway, without thinking, I took a few steps backwards, and then I stepped on a limb or something that made a cracking, loud, snapping sound. Oh boy, now it knew I was there. I had its attention. In horror, I watched as it quickly stood up and turned in my direction. Saying that I was scared at that moment was like saying the ocean is a little bit wet. I was terrified beyond words. I still have not found the right words after all this time to say what I felt in that moment. When it stood up, it had an aggressive and predatory posture. I can't tell you any better than that. If you've ever been in a predatory animal's focus, I don't have to explain it to you. If you've never been the focus of a predatory animal's gaze, I can't possibly explain it to you. I can only say that I could feel the danger and the malice emanating from that creature from that distance. And even that just doesn't do it justice. Now, I know that wisdom says not to run, not to look like prey. Don't trigger that chasing instinct from a predatory animal. But in my panic, I couldn't stop myself. I ran faster and longer than I think I ever have in my adult life. It's a wonder I didn't knock myself out running headlong into a tree. I was so scared, I kept looking back every half second or so. My fear really grew when I looked back, and I no longer saw the creature where it had been. I was looking wildly around, but I didn't see it coming up behind me. So I kept running, even though I didn't know where it went. Eventually, I found myself right back on the trail that I had left earlier, and I hightailed it all the way out as fast as I could. I don't think that creature followed me at all, or if it did, it didn't follow me far. Here are my thoughts on what happened, Nance. First, It is definitely a meat eater, and there was something in that posture when it stood up, when it knew I was there, that makes me absolutely certain that humans are on its menu. The best I can tell you is when it turned to look at me, it might as well have been a hungry lion looking at me. No, I wasn't close enough to see its facial expression, but I know to trust my gut feelings, and I'm telling you that it was sizing me up to maybe be the next snack on the menu. Second, I'm actually surprised that the creature didn't follow me. I believe it could have easily caught me with no effort if it had wanted to, and I don't know why it didn't. Maybe I didn't smell so good after I'd been out hiking and sweating all day. Maybe it was just satisfied with the kill it already had. I don't know. Third, I don't know where the rest of the animal that it had killed and was eating. I don't know what kind of animal it was. If I had to take a guess, it was maybe a coyote or a fox or a small deer. Maybe something about that size. Fourth, no clue on what it looked like. The whole thing, as I said, was backlit with sunlight from out in the open area beyond. I was mostly seeing outline and shadow. I do not even know exactly what color the Sasquatch was. And I do know it was a Sasquatch. I am sure of that. When it stood up, it was a solid 8 feet tall, I would say. There isn't a linebacker in the NFL that could compare with its torso mass. Never mind its height. Oddly, I don't remember much about its legs. I think I was so focused on the upper body that when it stood up, I couldn't see the legs. And yeah, it did have a pointy head. I did see all the things that I know everyone who is listening to this right now about the part where I was trying to figure out what I was seeing. I know what you're thinking. You were saying to yourself, "You dumbass, it's a Sasquatch, it's a Bigfoot." But that wasn't how it happens when you see one. At least it didn't with me. In closing, I'm just going to say that all of you can go ahead and take your oranges and bags of marshmallows out and leave gifts or whatever for those things if you want. But you're crazy if you do. Don't encourage them. Maybe the females aren't so aggressive, you know, like Patty in that film. I don't know. But I wouldn't bet my life on a big male. My whole encounter might have lasted a half minute, maybe even less, starting from when I first saw it until I began to reflexively run. And I can't help but think that there were many variables and many seconds along the way of that encounter where it all could have gone a different way. And it could have been my skull that Sasquatch was digging its fingers into later that day. But I made it out. And I have to say, I haven't been back in hiking for a while. And when I do, I never go alone. And I will never go alone again. Please don't even use my first name. Just call me Not a Squatch Snack. All right, well, holy crap, folks. Like I said, I couldn't wait to get this one out for you. I read this, and I think I read it through three more times. I just can't get over that skull snacking. I mean, I guess it makes sense. But, you know, all I really could think of when I got this email was the case that David Politis profiled. The one, I believe the child's name was Jared Atadero. The poor child. Anyway, all that was ever found of that child was the top part of his skull and a tooth. And I swear to my goodness, that was the only thing I could think of when I got this email. I know it doesn't make sense. And no, I don't think all the missing 411 are because of Sasquatch. But there was just something about the top part of a skull. Anyway, creepy, creepy. I tell you, I have to quit watching those missing people shows because I'm getting kind of spooked out. Okay, everyone. Well, I do hope you enjoyed this extra little encounter that I threw in today. I hope I get plenty more and I can start doing this more often instead of just 2 times a week. I'd like to go to more times a week, but I can only do that if you guys send in those encounters. So if you've got one, send it on in. If you've had an encounter with the big guy, send it to contact@buckeyebigfoot.com and tell me all about it so I can share it out with everyone else. All right, everyone, you know what I'm going to say. Until we meet up again, I'm Nance Warren, and I'll be putting the sass back into Sasquatch, and you guys are the Sass Squad. You're the backbone and the heartbeat of this channel. I love you all. Thanks for listening, everyone.